party. And that party's rated R.
Following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall, making its way to the ring from Toronto, Canada, weighing in at 241 pounds, is the World Heavyweight Champion, Edge!
The Rated R Superstar teams with Rey Mysterio to battle Kane and Alberto Del Rio next on SmackDown. Happy New Year's Eve, everyone. Welcome back to Friday Night SmackDown. We are all set for what is sure to be a blockbuster tag team match. Obviously, that is the World Heavyweight Champion Edge, set to team up with the greatest high flyer the WWE has ever seen, Rey Mysterio.
Happy New Year's Eve to you, Josh.
Appreciate it.
What about me?
Never, ever heard Happy New Year's Eve. I've heard Happy New Year's.
Or you can't say Happy New Year's Eve, Cole.
Not if you're a normal human being.
Okay. I like to wish everyone a Happy New Year's Eve.
You can say whatever you want when Rey Mysterio enters the arena.
And I'm sure you will.
Rey Mysterio!
You know, Matt, every once in a while I do come up with my own lines.
No, you don't.
Hey, guys, here's a novel idea. Maybe we talk about the real-life superhero, a video game in reality, SmackDown's Rey Mysterio.
A real-life superhero?
Yeah, Cole.
Why, because he runs around in a mask?
Let me tell you something, buddy. On this show, we actually try to talk about our superstars. Call it crazy. A two-time World Heavyweight Champion, Matt. Oh, yeah. And he belongs right here on Friday nights.
Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce Alberto Del Rio's personal ring announcer, Ricardo Rodriguez.
Damas y caballeros.
I love this guy.
Alberto Del Rio?
Oh, I love him. He's the future of Friday Night SmackDown.
Now.
You know, I'm really surprised that Alberto Del Rio brought that luxury automobile all the way up here to Rochester, New York. I mean, with all the snow we've been having in the Northeast as of late, I hope he understands if he gets some of that salt and sand on his car, going to cause some serious issues with the paint job.
Matt, throughout this match, I'd like for you to explain what motivates this savage aristocrat, Alberto Del Rio, with the bloodline of kings and old world money. I'm curious as to what you think drives Alberto Del Rio.
Well, you would think a man that has everything would be satisfied, but there is one reason that Alberto Del Rio is here on Friday Night SmackDown, and we'll get into it, at least in my opinion, as this match goes. Whoa!
Kane did last week. Edge gave him the opportunity for a rematch for the World Championship, and Kane said, I'm not going to take it tonight. I'm going to do things on my terms. I'm going to do things in my time. That was great psychology, I thought, from the former World Heavyweight Champion.
Well, it's Kane switching the tables. I mean, Edge played these mind games for months on Kane, and now Kane, ironically, is in the driver's seat. Is this car heading for a collision course? We'll find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Friday Night SmackDown. It is New Year's Eve. I can't think of a better way to ring in the new year than with four of SmackDown's top superstars involved in what is sure to be a star-studded tag team match.
Well, this is a rematch from the Fatal 4-Way where every superstar worked on their own for themselves. Question is, how will Alberto Del Rio and Kane work as a cohesive unit?
How great was that Fatal 4-Way matchup? Awesome. Tables, ladders, and chairs.
And obviously, it was Edge who came away as the new World Heavyweight Champion, but Alberto Del Rio
Boy.
Had a lot of people talking after TLC 2 weeks ago.
And Matt Ray and Edge have a great history together.
Sure, former tag team champions. They know each other's moveset so very well. Both of them are ring generals as well.
You know, I want to get to a point you said earlier. You know, 2011 for Alberto Del Rio. Is this going to be the year for this superstar?
Yes. I mean, I think so. I mean, how can you not? Anyone that's been watching since Alberto arrived on the scene, you have to be blind to not see what Alberto brings.
Josh?
Alberto Del Rio almost became the world heavyweight champion in 2010. I don't think there's anything that's
going
to stop Del Rio in 2011.
Wow.
Saw the dangers of this before.
And here comes Rey Mysterio, the tandem of Mysterio. That was innovative. Mysterio and the World Heavyweight Champion rolling. Can they keep it going? We'll find out when SmackDown returns. Welcome back to Friday Night SmackDown. Huge tag team matchup here. The World Heavyweight Champion Edge teaming up with Rey Mysterio.
Hey, easy on the red
to take. It's New Year's Eve, Cole. I'm fired up.
Fire up, boys.
And now the former World Heavyweight Champion taking it to Edge.
What a rivalry developed in the latter part of 2010 between these two superstars, Edge and Kane. Edge, the master manipulator, using mind games to really wrestle away that World Heavyweight Championship.
And Michael, to your point, I mean, the World Heavyweight Championship is the holy grail to Kane. What do you think Kane meant when he said, on my terms?
Well, he's going to pick the time and place.
Oh, kick your eye on Del Rio.
When Edge least expects it. When Edge is perhaps at his most vulnerable.
Gosh, think of the macabre of what Kane's terms must entail.
Tag there by Kane to the aristocrat Alberto Del Rio. Matt, you believe that Del Rio is motivated by simply being the best, by one day being World Heavyweight Champion. As Del Rio goes for the cover.
Well, you begged the question earlier. Listen, Alberto Del Rio seems to have everything.
Yeah, you're not disgusted enough by Del Rio. Think
about
the fact that his offspring's offspring will be completely set financially for the rest of their lives.
Absolutely. That's a great point.
Shoots the half, does Del Rio.
So you have a problem with that? You forget who runs our company, right?
It's Alberto's ego. Alberto Del Rio cannot stand the fact that the world adores someone like Rey Mysterio. Shouldn't they adore me, Alberto thinks? I have everything.
Another cover here by Del Rio.
So it's ego, it's narcissism, and it's jealousy, and those are very powerful emotions that can fuel the rage inside of Alberto Del Rio.
And what fuels the rage inside this man, the demented Kane?
The Burning Man, his black heart, with his lifetime of torture. The desire and enjoyment that Kane gets out of inflicting pain.
And he really had the tables turned on him, though, when Edge started to play the mind games for the last few months.
Well, we talked about it. I mean, who can physically defeat Kane? I mean, you can probably count those people. Hang on.
Covered here by Kane on Edge.
On one hand. So Edge took a very enlightened approach. If I can't beat you up physically, I can definitely outthink you, and that's how I can get to you. And Edge proved the case. He's the World Heavyweight Champion.
And here comes Kane there. Nice counter by Edge. And now it's a counter by Kane, and Edge quickly turns things around. And we've forgotten about Rey Mysterio throughout this match. Rey ready to get involved. And here comes the master of the 619, Rey Mysterio, so comfortable on the top rope. Now building up some steam. Great move there by Rey. Taking out the leg of the bigger man.
Let's not forget the history between Kane and Rey Mysterio from 2010. It was back in July where Kane won the Money in the Bank ladder match and cashed in on the same night to take the world championship.
Wow. That'll change the entire complexion of this match.
Kane perhaps sensing it as well, slowing things down completely here. And Mysterio crashes to the floor.
Well, that's good. And look at this. Great. The veteran Kane. Distracting the referee and allows Del Rio to get in a cheap shot.
That's the chaos of these type of matches. I mean, the referee is in an unenviable position to try to maintain order.
And I suppose you guys would give credit to Alberto Del Rio for interjecting himself into the match.
You got to do what you got to do to win.
Listen, dude, I'm not going to say I'm going to give him credit, but you have to admit it's smart.
Okay.
You know?
you put yourself in the position that these superstars
hold on
are in.
1 second. Kane hooks the leg on Mysterio.
I mean, it's all about being the best. It's all about being world champion. You have to do anything you can to get to the point where you can become world champion. These superstars are so evenly matched in so many different facets of their game.
Del Rio with the cover once again.
That if you got to take a cheap shot every once in a while, you do that to get better. I mean, look what the Miz has accomplished over on Monday Night Raw. He's the WWE champion. Yes, he takes cheap shots.
It only took you over an hour to mention this.
Oh, nice. Hope he's having a good New Year's Eve.
Cover here by Alberto Del Rio. Tight cover. The kick out by Ray. Too much.
Listen, say what you want about Alberto, but how astute, how brilliant is this? The body scissors underneath the ribs cuts off the flow of oxygen and compromises Rey Mysterio.
That anyone questions the in-ring ability of Alberto.
You just don't like his tactics.
I don't like his tactics.
So your opinion is that if Alberto's so good, why does he resort to those underhanded tactics? That's what upsets you?
Sure, it upsets me.
Okay.
In the Del Rio Mysterio rivalry, even though it only went on for a few months, many consider this the rivalry of 2010 on SmackDown.
What about the fact that Alberto Del Rio came to Friday Night SmackDown with an agenda? Del Rio's agenda was to take out Rey Mysterio, and the newcomer was successful in doing so, fracturing Rey Mysterio's arm.
Oh, man, what a tilt world backbreaker.
This may do it. Del Rio with the cover. Is it over now?
So impressive, though. Del Rio's got all the tools.
And listen, Rey's style, that lucha libre style, has its roots and its heritage in Mexico. Alberto Del Rio grew up watching and studying the style. If anyone has the counter to Rey Mysterio's offense, it may very well be Alberto Del Rio.
And Del Rio's got such great veteran instincts in the ring. Notice how he backed into the corner with Rey, allowing Kane to make the tag, then wrapped Rey's arm around the top rope.
I'm impressed with the way that Kane and Alberto Del Rio have been able to work together here, using their power and strength to dominate Rey Mysterio.
Focus now is turned to the back of Mysterio. And again, to take the back out, Mysterio can't roll around the ring and fly around the ring to the best of his ability.
This could become Jane Lynch ugly real quick.
So what's the strategy, Matt?
For Rey Mysterio to use his speed and quickness and make a tag to the world's heavyweight champion. For Kane, it's to ground Rey Mysterio and corner the luchador.
And Mysterio! Only Rey Mysterio can pull that off. Turning point in the match here, perhaps, if Rey Mysterio can turn just the other way and make his way over to the World Heavyweight Champion Edge. Kane starting to stir. Here comes Del Rio, and here comes the World Heavyweight Champion. And Edge building momentum. This counter here by Del Rio. Alberto Del Rio keeping his head in this. Del Rio's head off the canvas.
And this is where Edge is so lethal. Creating space, creating distance. Last time, speed equals force.
We all know the place where Edge is going right now. The intensity in the eyes of the World Heavyweight Champion. Just waiting and stalking Del Rio.
Oh, wow.
Kane with the interception.
Oh, that's great teamwork.
And here comes Edge.
Edge and Del Rio illegal.
619 spear. Del Rio down, and it's over.
An explosion here.
Rey Mysterio and the World Heavyweight Champion, the Rated R Superstar Edge.
Guys, I'll tell you one thing. It's okay for you to want to be like Edge and Rey Mysterio, because trust me, your friends do too. Huge victory for Mysterio and Edge.
Here, congratulations, Edge and Rey Mysterio.
A great win for the World Heavyweight Champion and Rey Mysterio.